people think meth users are dirty and like druggies and like bad, real bad people. They're not bad, they just have a problem.
Well, it starts out, it's cool. You know, it's fun. It's an experience. Then people who have been into it for about, say, anywhere from 3 months, depending on how much they're doing, to half a year, they don't really like it too much anymore. It's depressing almost. It's like almost like your world's coming down around you, but it actually does come down around you.
Methamphetamines are nothing new. In fact, we've had methamphetamines for over a century, actually. But it's only been since about the 70s and 80s that we've actually gotten into a new phase where we've found, you know, synthetic recipes that we can actually cook it up fairly quickly. You don't need a lab now, like what we used to have. You don't need anything, you know, terribly exotic to be able to make it. Well, the ingredients come from some profoundly toxic substances that are available to the common public.
I've had people come to me and like, come on, do meth, it's good, man, it's cool. Like, look at everyone doing it, man. And I did it because it looked cool and I was only 12, right? And it's not cool at all, it's not.
There's many different reasons why people use meth. Some people use it for weight loss, some people use it just for the high. And I don't know, people use it for their insecurities and the way that they get looked at and peer pressure.
Hey, man.
What's up?
Hi.
What's up?
Not much. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Hey.
Bad.
What you playing?
Go Postal.
Sweet.
You want a pillow?
No, thanks.
So what are you guys up to?
Nothing much. We're just hanging, playing some Xbox. How about you?
Well, you know, same old, same old. Actually, we're looking for some grass. We're celebrating. It's our 6 month anniversary.
Sorry, not selling anymore, Matt.
What? Since when?
Since I started going to college.
When is she gonna go to college and stop smoking grass?
Yeah.
You gonna be a doctor or a lawyer?
Maybe.
Yeah.
You know what, Matt? I think that's great.
Thanks.
Yeah, real great. Where am I gonna get some grass now?
I don't know. It's not my problem.
Hey, Sam, you know where to get some?
Yeah, I'm going to a party later on. There'll probably be something there.
Right on. Where's that at?
It's just a couple blocks from here.
Sweet. Sounds good. But we're gonna jet here. See you guys later.
Nice to see you, man.
Thanks a lot, eh?
Hey, Kyle. I don't really want to go to the party tonight. I thought it was just gonna be the two of us.
It will be, all right? We're just gonna go and we'll get our grass, say hi, and leave, all right?
Are you sure?
Yeah. It won't be long.
Okay.
Funny how that guy only comes around when you got a pot kicking around.
You're telling me.
So you ever gonna make a move on Christy?
She's with Kyle.
So?
If you were to sell it, you'd make a lot of money, but it's downhill in the end, always. I've never known one person who sold drugs that came out ahead.
A few of them, I don't know exactly what they do to get the money, but they get it.
It screwed me up. Like, half my friends I thought were good friends, right? Apparently not.
Did you deal with it? And then I went to school the next day, and it was gone.
Like, I don't know. Yeah, it's pretty hard. Eh?
So there's something. I was, you know, so scared about like the cops finding out and my parents trying to. So
yeah.
I just didn't do anything, and you know, told my mom. You know,
that's
some
so
story,
funny.
You know? Yeah, yeah.
Hey, Carly.
I'll talk to you later. good. How you doing?
Pretty good.
Yeah. Hey, Kyle. We're not gonna stay very long, are we?
No, just we'll grab our grass and we'll go, alright?
Alright.
Alright, let's go. Hey, how's it going?
Hey, Kyle, how's it going? I haven't seen you in so long. Where you been keeping yourself?
I know, I'm just around.
Oh, yeah?
So where you been?
Just been around.
Yeah, do you even go to school anymore or what?
No. Hey, who did you come here with?
Oh, my girlfriend, Christy. Christy, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, we're actually looking for some grass. You guys wouldn't know where to find some, would you?
Can't help you out, man. I just sold my last quarter to some kids who came here about half an hour ago.
No way.
Look, but I got some meth if you want. It's only 20 bucks. Want it?
I don't know.
Why not?
I'm not really into the man-made shit.
Well, it's way better than pot, trust me. It'll keep you up all night.
Mix in a bathtub or
something? No, it's good stuff. Trust me.
Come on, try some. Stay well.
Yeah, it's only 20 bucks. I do it. It's really good.
Do you want to try some first?
Yeah, totally.
Alright, so how do I do this?
Okay, you just snort it, alright? Yeah, do it up. How was that? It's not bad, eh?
No. That's pretty good.
Here, let me do that.
So how much was it?
20 bucks. You want it?
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, babe. You got the money?
Yeah, did you get some grass?
They don't have any grass, actually, but I got some meth.
Meth?
Yeah.
What's the pot?
Well, they don't have any pot. But it's good stuff, trust me. Do you want to try one, babe?
Yeah, you want some?
It's not gonna hurt you.
See? So where's all your beer?
Want me to grab you one?
You want a beer? Two.
A lot of the symptoms about crystal meth are the same as amphetamines. What makes it different is that one, that is synthetic. it's very available. It's very cheap. And relatively speaking, we find that it is more addicting than what we've had on the street regarding speed in the past.
There was a lot of crowds doing it. Everybody did it. I don't know whether it was cool or what it was, but it is addictive when you don't know what you're doing. And yeah, a lot of kids were doing it. Like, say, anywhere from 40 to 50% of school populations, I bet.
When they're high, the world's a beautiful place and everyone's their friend and, you know, hey, let's go and start a commune and we can all be happy and this and that. It's when they're down, which everyone sucks.
That's how it starts out. They start doing it social and then they come dependent on it, you know what I mean? So then that's all they know for right then is, got to get meth, got to get it in me.
Anyone else?
Oh, man.
Come here. So, how you been?
Not very good, man.
Yeah, you look like shit.
Yeah.
Look, we need a favor.
A favor?
Yeah, just like a gram or something.
You already owe me money.
Look, I know, I'll get you the money. I'll give you my ring.
Give you 2 points for it.
2 points? I was kind of hoping for a gram.
A gram? I think you're coming over here to pay me money, and you want a gram?
Look, 2 points ain't gonna last us, man. Look, I'll pay you. I don't have anything left. I sold a TV and a stereo. Like, we got nothing. What am I supposed to do?
Maybe we can cut a deal.
Like what?
Lend her to me for half an hour.
That's worth more than a gram.
Fine, I'll give you an 8.
An 8-ball? What about our debt?
Fine, you got that clear too.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Kyle?
What? Oh. It's an 8-ball. You got a better way to get an 8-ball?
Do you want the meth or not?
It's just half an hour, all right? Just do a bit and forget about it.
Maybe the first year not doing it, I'd never do that. But you know, the second year, then you're pretty dependent on it, and you get sick if you don't do it. You know, like you feel just down. And it comes down to that.
This one couple that would come by the house, their whole relationship was built around meth. And when they were high, they were the most perfect couple on the planet, and you know. Always holding hands and kissing and stuff, but as soon as they were down, I mean, the gloves came off and they were at war.
I've had adults whose relationships wind up on the rocks because they have this classical conditioning of sex and drugs, especially stimulants, right? And then when you take a look at the crash after they quit using, the anhedonia, that not finding pleasure in a lot of things, has a profound negative effect on relationships, sexual intimacy, all of that.
Causes problems in relationships. I think if somebody's been doing drugs and they come into a relationship and they're doing drugs, they ever want to quit. I don't think the relationship could keep on going if they're both doing it. You know, one of them would have to be clean through the whole relationship.
Hey, babe.
Sold me for meth?
Look, I didn't sell you for meth, alright? It was just an arrangement.
An arrangement.
Look, you didn't have to do it.
You didn't give me an option.
You always have an option. You just gotta speak up a little.
You treated me like I was some kind of object, like I wasn't even there.
Well, you were there, so if you had a problem, you should have said something.
I tried to.
I don't know what the big deal is. I didn't sleep with him.
We have to quit.
What?
We have to quit.
Why? What? Fine, we'll quit.
Not a big problem.
Want some of this? It's the last of it.
Usually with adults, we find that they'll be doing it in context with something else, like perhaps replacing Coke or something like that at a time. But for youth, it's not that way at all. What we find is that people are using crystal meth specifically for its own, you know, this kind of thing. And the side effects can be profound, you know, disastrous.
I don't really know about health effects. But, like, I've been in the hospital a few times. I've actually had blackouts, but I don't think it's because of the drug. I think it's just because the drug makes it so that you don't eat.
I've seen people get bleeding noses out of nowhere, to fainting, to barely even able to move.
It's just an easier way of, like, getting skinnier and, I don't know, thinking you're cool because everyone's doing it, and if you're in the rave scene, then you think you're, like, popular because then everyone around you is doing it. And
I only blacked out for a few seconds. Like, I was just walking, and I blacked out and fell. Like, I heard myself fall, but I didn't see it, and I woke up pretty much instantly to my mom hanging over me. And then she moved me to the couch, and I laid there, and I went into shock. My whole body went completely numb. I couldn't feel anything. I couldn't move. I was just basically all tensed up.
When you stop, you eat a lot more. It's like, you didn't eat for that 3 days, so you're gonna eat a lot. I don't know. That's one thing I did anyway. Some people don't, though. You know, they try and stay skinny.
Not too much yourself?
You know, just walking around.
Oh, yeah. Hey, this is my friend Gary.
Yo, how you doing?
Hey.
So, you don't look so good. What have you been doing with yourself?
Nothing, that's the problem.
Oh, yeah?
I've been clean for like a month. It's driving me crazy.
No kidding. Why?
Well, the woman's all,
I can't quit.
Kyle, why do you let her tell you what to do with your life? I mean, like, there are plenty of girls who'd be lucky to have you. Just don't let her boss you around, man.
Yeah, whatever. What can I do about it?
Well, we're gonna go to a friend's house. Do you wanna come? We could do a couple rails later.
You got some with you?
Yeah, I always got some with me. Come on, hop in.
All right.
Yeah, people always try to get you to use again. Come on, man, it'll be all right. You can use just this once more, you know? It's all good. I won't tell anybody. That's where you go. I won't tell anybody. Oh, he's using again, you know? Like, and it becomes a big story.
We get a lot of folks that wind up having problems with sexual issues with the drugs as well. And what I mean by sexual issues is everything from, I've had adults that, whose relationships wind up on the rocks because they have this classical conditioning of sex and drugs, especially stimulants, right? And then when you take a look at the crash after they quit using, the anhedonia, the not finding pleasure in a lot of things, has a profound negative effect on relationships, sexual intimacy, all of that.
Well, two of my friends that were very, very close got into the drug, and when they didn't have the drug, they were fighting a lot more. When one of them got the drug, they'd keep it to themselves, and it would start huge problems between the two of them. And they were only together for about a month, a month after they both got into it.
Hey.
Oh, hey, man.
Hey, what's up, man? What's up?
Not much.
So what are you up to, man? What have you been doing?
Not much. Just studying, you know?
Yeah.
What about you? Stuff?
Just chilling out, walking around, you know? So what have you been doing, man? I haven't seen you forever.
I've been really busy with school.
Oh, yeah. So what are you up to? What are you doing?
I'm studying. I just told you that a couple of minutes ago.
Yeah, sorry, a little absent-minded.
Are you okay, man?
Yeah, man, I'm good.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Because you look a little strung out.
No, man, no, I drank a little too much coffee and got in my head.
Whatever.
Listen, I gotta get going, but great seeing you, man. Call me sometime.
Yeah, okay.
See you, man.
Doesn't matter how crappy your day's going, I mean, do some math and poof, you're on top of the world. Doesn't matter if you just got the crap kicked out of you, or you just got disowned by your family, or not any of it. Just kind of takes it all away.
So how do they talk to you about it, right? How do they approach you and say, hey, we're worried, we're wondering about if something's going on, because what are you going to say, right? Especially when it's a drug that you feel better on this thing, you know, or more competent or able to deal with things when you're on this than not. You're probably not going to think that this is any kind of a problem whatsoever. So of course, you know, there's no problem. So of course it's interfering with the communication.
Come in. Matt!
Hey.
How's it going?
Not bad.
Hey. So, what are you doing here?
Just was in the neighborhood. Decided to stop by and say hi.
Alright. Well, why don't you come in and have a seat?
Sure. Place looks nice and tidy.
Yeah. I got some free time on my hands.
So when did you guys start using again?
What are you talking about?
You and Kyle. When did you guys start using meth again?
Oh, no, me and Kyle, we quit 3 months ago. We've been clean.
You're clean?
Yeah.
I saw Kyle today, walking down the street, strung out like an idiot. I didn't even think he knew I was there.
It must have been somebody else, because we quit.
I know what I saw, okay? He was tweaking.
You know what, Matt? I have a lot of things I gotta do, so you should probably go now.
Whatever. Look, when you're tired of going nowhere, with a loser like Kyle, give me a call.
You can say you want to quit as many times as you want, but is it going to happen? Who knows? I've seen lots of friends that have quit using meth. And their outlook looking back has always been like, I can't believe I was doing that. I mean, the stories they tell me are just insane.
But then when you come down, you just look at your life and you're just like, why can't I quit? Why not? Why do I keep going back? But you always end up going back the next day or whatnot. You know, it's just like, you see the problem, you just don't stop it because you just want to do it again.
Going for a walk.
Yeah?
Yeah, I had some things I had to think about. Huh. What the hell is that?
What?
Kyle, this is bull. You know what? When Matt told me you were using again, I gave you the benefit of the doubt.
Matt?
Yeah.
So you're sleeping with Matt now?
No, I'm not sleeping with Matt. This isn't about Matt. This is about you lying to me and using again.
I'm not using again. I just need a little bit, all right? You don't have a craving?
No, that's bull. That's it. We're through. I'm leaving.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
Yeah, where are you gonna stay?
With a friend?
What friend?
Maybe I'll stay with Matt.
Want some of this?
What I did is whenever I wanted the drug, I would just go around somebody that knew that I had that problem and was completely there for my support, and I just stayed around them. I'd go to the mall with my sisters, basically just do something that takes your mind off of it.
Not worth it, man. You just find yourself looking Jones in the streets or yellow receipts, as my friend would say.
Always keep with it. Just because there's one bump in the road doesn't mean you can't do it still, you know? It's hard, but keep with it.
There's a lot about life that's worth celebrating, and there's a lot about life that if it doesn't feel like celebrating, you can get yourself to a place where life can be better than you ever imagined. You know, and you don't need to have something synthetic that you're going to stick in your body that's going to give you a shortcut. It doesn't work like that. If you're genuinely that unhappy about life, or if you're genuinely that interested in taking some risks, okay, there are some fabulous ways of doing it. There are people out there that are genuinely interested in seeing you make the changes, seeing you have the kind of life you really want to have. This is one of the ones where it's almost like out of 1984, you know, if we could invent a drug that would be terribly addictive, easy to make with all the kind of readily available ingredients, this is the one. This is the one.
You want some of this?